For sunny.
In the sun.
Well, I declare. Mm-hmm. And there's a squirrel in there.
These squirrels are not too bright.
Now, that animal, how old would that be?
He is. Can you read his sign back there? The green sign, can you see it?
Joseph.
19.
What green sign are you talking about?
Yeah, all of the cats, I put a sign on them that says their name and their age because people always want to know how old they are and I can never remember.
Okay, 98.
Yeah, 98.
So
August
he'll be 20 this year.
20, well, and then people that. Years.
Times 6, so he's 120 years old.
Wow.
That's why he's so skinny.
120 years old.
And grouchy.
Well, I'd let him win.
And then way back at this page, there's a tiger named Zeus.
Zeus
is striped under the platform there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I see
that. He's even older, isn't he? 96?
Yeah, he's 21.
Look at the squirrel. Well, when is squirrel season?
I think the reason the squirrels hang out back here is because the big cats don't think that they're big enough to eat, and so they don't bother them. And squirrels actually steal the meat off the plate and eat it, which
really?
Is kind of weird. Cause
I
never
didn't
thought
know
squirrels
that.
Were carnivorous.
Me either. I didn't know that. So is this the time of day that they've eaten and now they're taking a little nap? Or?
Man.
Yeah.
Boy, he's a whopper, isn't he?
They're mainly night. They like to be out at night.
And they're old. These guys are 22 years old.
Hello there, buddy. Man, 22 years old.
That one's pretty.
Did you get him when he was just little?
He came in 2011. That's Andre. And then you can see his brother, I think, in the den right there. See the stripes in the den?
See his ears?
Oh, yeah.
You see it half a head and one ear?
It's probably... Or
peeking out the door here.
Well, you want to rub his head, wouldn't you? But it wouldn't be advisable, would it?
Nope, they could take your arm off just like that. Good morning, Karma. Do you know where Amanda is?
She is chewed down, probably in her den.
Are you fixing feeding breakfast?
So, well, I fed him, but he was acting like he didn't feel very good. He was really drooling, and he didn't eat very much, so I'm going to see if he'll stick feed any of it, and if not, then somebody will go out a little bit.
Can we watch?
Absolutely.
Now all of these cages are joined. They're bubbles, but they've got adjoining
tunnels. Right there, you can see one of the tunnels.
Okay.
So they can go from where you saw the lion
Something
all the way down to the end here.
When he's not hungry. Look at him. They don't like what you're serving today. What is that you're feeding him?
This is chicken, and then I'm trying to feed what the chickens are, and piece of red meat, like steak.
Like steak? I don't even get any steak.
Tom's going to be over here all the time. That noise you're hearing is the Veterans Expressway, which is right behind the trees.
Push it in there. Now chew it up good. He done swallowed it, hadn't he?
Man. He likes to be better.
Well, he's
chicken
a big one, isn't he, when he stands up?
He's probably about 450 pounds.
Is that all you're
going to
eat?
Usually when they start licking their paws, that's the indicator to the keepers that they're not going to eat anymore. That's why she asked him if he was
down.
Yeah. He just dropped
him. He doesn't even chew it up, does he?
No.
How's he taste it? Is that medium rare or what?
I think it's rare.
Very rare.
Yeah, they won't eat it if you cook it.
Is that a fact?
They know there's no nutrition in cooked meat. All the nutrition is in the raw stuff. Mm-hmm.
Well, you feed him till he gets full?
Yeah, until he doesn't want it anymore. He didn't want the chicken, so I'll feed him all the red I have.
Mm-hmm. They pack their buckets full of different things. Turkey and chicken and beef and pork and try to figure out what the cat wants that day because every day it's something different but you don't know till you get here what it is.
How often do you feed him? Once a day?
Once a day. But some of these big
do you do when one of them dies?
I'm afraid all I got left is chicken.
When they die, we do an autopsy, just like you would with a human, to see if there's anything that we can learn from their death. Of course, in our cats that are like over 20, we don't do an autopsy because it's a miracle they live that long. So there's not anything we can learn by that, other than to feed them well and give them good vet care.
Do you have a burial ground, or what do you do?
And then they're cremated.
Cremated.
So we have a...
Well, he's a cute little thing.
Pretty.
I'd like to rub the top of his head.
We can bring him back some steak.
This big cage that we just passed here is our This is our vacation rotation. And all of the lions and tigers get a two-week vacation out there that we always all of themselves. And today is usually the day that we move everybody to and from vacation. But we're running behind. Probably going to be tomorrow.
They can't get over that fence.
She is really fit and really mean, and so we were worried that she might just go right over the top, and so we put that there so that if she's climbing upside down, she can't get a paw over the top lip. Oh, there she is, right there in the, couldn't see her, she's right there underneath that platform.
Okay, yeah, ooh, hey, you missed her, man. Stand up there, sweetie.
Oh. Like, I heard my vacation.
She's the only one in there?
Yeah, she's the only one. The only time that they go out there in groups is if they were raised together. So, like those three tigers we just saw, those are siblings and they could come out here together. But if we were to take any other tiger and put them in there with her, they'd kill each other.
Well, they know, they recognize their siblings?
Well, because they've been living together the whole time. Even if they'd been separated at birth and put back together, they'd kill each other.
Is that right?
Because they're solitary by nature. She has mammary cancer.
Oh,
she's
that's
20,
a fine treat, I tell you.
I
never dreamed they would get to a tour like this.
So next, not this Saturday, but next Saturday, she's going to have a
the buzzes here.
We don't want them here.
Oh, you don't? Well, I thought maybe that's part of the show.
No.
Oh, wait. Well, he looks like he's been well fed.
No kittens for you, or anybody else. all of the cages for tigers have these pools. And that solar panel array over there brings the water up out of the lake so that it's always fresh water in all of the pools that you see along there.
Any fish in there?
Lots of fish. You don't, we don't fish in there.
You don't fish in there.
The Christmas trees had that great smell, and so the cats like to smell them, they like to pee on them, some of them like to drag them around the cage and tear them up, so it's just something for them to play with.
They get bored.
Yeah. Because in the wild, they'd be roaming like hundreds of square miles of territory, and here, you know, they've got like 1,800 square feet there, keep that maybe 3/4 of an acre. But that's just nothing compared to what they should be living in. There's one up on the platform.
Yeah, I see him. I didn't even see that. No
one. Oh, and then the white tiger behind here, yeah. So the one closest to you is Priya, and the one, the white tiger, is Sapphire. Priya came here from a facility that when they went under, they had 110 big cats that had gone to sanctuaries.
Wow.
And then Sapphire, the white tiger, was actually seized by the Department of Ohio, or the Ohio Department of Agriculture, from a person who didn't have a license. And so what we do is we give them a place to keep the cats while they're suing the owners.
Oh, I
this has been a 4-year long lawsuit.
Wow.
And they just look like a statue, doesn't it? Doesn't it? Hello, buddy.
Hey,
how's it going?
This is Tommy.
We'll be all right, me. Rub his hands?
No.
You don't know. Oh, me.
None of us touched the cat. For two reasons. One is they pulled my whole body through that 4-inch hole because they're pound for pound, they're 12 times stronger than a human. But the other reason is they're not dead. She was actually born in a traveling wagon that was left out front of another sanctuary in Georgia. The guy was breeding and using cubs, and when he couldn't use the adults anymore, he just loaded them all up into a big wagon and set it off in front of a sanctuary, which is like my worst nightmare that somebody's going to do that to me. And her mom apparently was pregnant, so she was born right here on the...
What does it mean, supported by?
For a sign like this, it means that they donate at least $500 a year to take care of her.
Okay.
And then like that person up there, or actually it's a business, but I think they donate, mom probably know better than I do, is that a $5,000 sign?
Well, at least $2,500. I don't know now what it might be. It used to be $2,500, but that was years ago.
Well, I imagine they have pretty good appetite.
A cat like her can eat $10,000 worth of food a year. So just the food and
she's particular what she eats, huh? She likes
steak.
A lot of it, too. Steak and a lot of it.
And they buy their steak from the same places that, that restaurants get their food.
Is that a fact? You mean it's not just cold stuff,
no,
huh?
No, it's really it's good stuff. This is Orion, and Orion has this cage, and then if you can see that whole tunnel system and all those cages over there, so there's three cages over there and this cage that are all connected, and there's three siblings who live together, Aries, Orion, and Artemis. A hunter shot their mom and was going to try and make pets out of him, but his brother turned him in, and so the cats were confiscated.
Oh, he makes you just want to go up there and rub his back, doesn't he?
They look so sweet and gentle.
Yeah, he looks like he'd just be so gentle.
Usually when food's involved, that's a whole different cat. White tiger again, Sapphire.
Hey, buddy.
It's a girl, I think, though. Sapphire.
It's not like lions, is it, Tom?
Give you an idea of how strong she is. She really likes this male tiger next door. And so every time she sees him, she tries to get over there in his cage. And look how she's bowed out the edge of that feeding box, just banging on that with her head.
She's wanting out of that, wasn't she?
Well, on those balls, they can pick those huge balls up with their mouth.
With their mouth?
They do what now?
Like 90 pounds, because they're really thick.
How'd she get a hold of it?
With her teeth?
Just the sharp teeth. They stick it in there. If you look at the ball, it's full of holes.
Well, what do you think about that?
Yeah, that ball's really torn.
You can imagine what they do to your head.
Yeah, well, no, I won't imagine. Boy, this is something else. Else.
That ball, you can see, is really torn up. And the tiger up on the platform there?
I see.
That's Hoover. Hoover actually was rescued from Peru. Most of our cats come from the United States, from people that, unfortunately, people will pay to have their picture made with a cub, and then they can't use them very long, and so the people that do that kind of business will just give them away a lot of times to people as pets. And a year later, that cat's 200 pounds, 300 pounds, and people can't get rid of him fast enough. So, in his case, he was in a circus, and in Peru, they outlawed the circus using big cats. So the circus went on the run, and this company called Animal Defenders International chased him for over a year trying to catch the circus.
Uh-huh.
And by the time they caught up, there were 12 tigers originally, and 11 of them had died by the time they caught up, and this was the only one to survive. And then it took another year and a half to get through all the paperwork to get him here to the U.S.
What do you think about that?
He came on a big cargo plane with a shipment full of Mother's Day flowers. It was really something to see them take all those flowers off the plane, and then there's Hoover.
Oh, me. Now, those birds, did you transport them in here? Or?
There's a pig farm right on the other side of that white wall back there. Uh-huh. And so I think that's what attracts them. Because we picked up the food right after we feed the cats.
Oh,
so don't get anything.
This is Duchess.
And she's another one of the cats who is in the, we call it the Witness Protection Program, because she was seized by the Ohio Department of Agriculture.
Well, you would just like to rub his back, wouldn't you?
I know better.
I know it would.
She swamped you down pretty quick with that big tail.
And you got pretty strong tents, I too, haven't you?
The state says you have to have a tiger behind a 9-gauge fence, and all of ours are 5 and 6-gauge, which is much thicker. The lower the number, the thicker the fence. Because we don't want any of them running loose.
And you don't want anybody feeding them, do you?
No, we want to, whenever people come for tours, it's always like this. There's a tour guide with them to make sure that they aren't trying to pet the tigers. Or feed them something that
poisons them. So do you have regular times for tours, or do you, is it just a...
Yeah, every day at 3 o'clock we have a tour, and then on the weekends we have 3 or 4 tours throughout the day, because most people are off on the weekend.
Which one of these size tigers is Samson took off?
Samson?
Samson, in the Bible.
Wouldn't it a lion?
Yeah, I guess it's a lion, wouldn't it? Yeah, it's
so
a lion.
What's
the difference between a lion and a tiger?
Stripes.
That's what I was thinking. I say, as far as fighting was concerned, it wouldn't matter, it wouldn't make much difference, would it?
No. In fact, people ask all the time, if a lion and a tiger got in a fight, who would win? Every time they ask me that, I say, well, they don't live on the same continent, so it's not going to happen. But if it happened, it'd be a pretty even match. This is Manny. He's a jaguar.
Hey, Mandy.
I didn't, it's
real
fly,
jaguar.
I didn't know you had jaguars.
He's new.
Yeah. Oh.
He came here from, he and a very rare, there's an Amur leopard here named Natalia now that came with him. Mm. And there's only like 41 of them left in the wild. And jaguar is like my daughter's favorite animal ever.
Oh, that's pretty. That's pretty awesome. Yes. Yes.
They look like those spots are painted on. They eat crocodiles.
Crocodiles?
Really? They kill and eat crocodiles for fun.
Well,
yeah, I guess the crocodiles allow for that. Man.
Well, so do you feed them
crocodiles?
No.
How did y'all get this started? A little at a time, or?
I've done bobcat rehab and release since I was like 17 years old. And the leopard right there.
Some Dari.
What's baby in it?
Well, she's They're going to be 22 this year.
22.
But in 1992, my late husband and I were buying llamas because I'm in real estate for a living. So this was back then it was a 40-acre tract of land. Now it's 67 acres. But what we would do is we'd buy llamas and turn them loose on the property, and they clear about eye level, and then you move them to the next piece of property. So we're at this auction, and the guy comes up, and he's selling a six-month-old bobcat. And the guy next to me starts bidding on it. I lean over to him, and I said, when that cat grows up, she's going to tear your face off. And he said, I'm a taxidermist. I'm just going to club her in the head in the parking lot and make a den decoration out of her. So I started crying, and my husband started bidding, and we probably paid more for that bobcat than anybody's ever paid for a bobcat in the history of bobcats, but she was not going to get clubbed in the head in the parking lot. So she came home, and her name was Winsong, and she started the whole sanctuary.
Lovely. That's how it got started.
So the jaguar spots are like rosettes, and these are just
spots.
Can you tame one so that you can get like a kitty cat?
No. In fact, best example of that is the one that you just saw, Sundari.
Mm-hmm.
We don't breed cats anymore here because we don't believe they belong in cages. But when we first started, people told us, oh, these are endangered species, which they are. And they don't do well in zoos, and they were saying, well, you should be breeding them so that we have them for future generations. And so I thought that was true. Come to find out it's not true, because none of these cats can ever go free if they've been born in a cage. The only cats who ever get a chance to go free are those that are born in the wild. But anyway, I didn't know any better, 20 years ago, however old Sundari is. And her mom, when she had them, didn't know what to do with them, and so about 7 o'clock in the morning, somebody comes pounding on my door, because I used to live in the gift shop, and they said, there's something really gross in Nyla's cage, you gotta come see this. Well, what it was her and her sister still in the sack. And her sister was a black leopard, and she was golden, and I ripped the sack off of both of them, and they gave them both mouth to mouth, and I was able to revive her, but not the other one. So, as soon as I got her breathing, I took her back to her mom, and I was like, look, it's yours, it's a kitten, this is what it is, that's what's in the sack. And the mother didn't want anything to do with it. So I tried feeding her, you know, until she was big enough that she was like fluffy, she looked like a leopard. Took her back to her mom, and her mom was like, I don't know what that is, I don't want any part of
it. What do you think of
it? So I bottle raised her, she slept in my bed, you know, she was my child for 2 years. But once they get to be 2 or 3 years old, then they become adults. Uh-huh. And once they become adults, they'll kill their own mother to take over the territory. So it doesn't matter how close you are to them.
Huh?
Well, it's time for me to go. That's what she said. One of us had to live in a cage. Guess who got got chosen for that one?
Is that some of your workers there, or are they?
Those are interns, and our interns come from all around the world.
Is that
they
a fact?
Those mobile homes that you saw outside the gates, and they stay with us for 3 months at a time, and then they can come back for another stint and another stint, so they can come up to 5 times.
Oh.
That lady that you guys saw feeding the cat, she came back 5 times, and she was like, "What can I do next?" And we didn't have a number 6 times. We were like, "Well, maybe we'll just hire her." So she works in the gift shop, but she still volunteers.
This is something else.
He died on his birthday.
This is the last big project that my dad built. It was called the Funcation, and it's 22,000 square feet, and it's a place for the little cats to go on vacation.
Okay.
So cats that size are up to the size of leopards. So that's why we put the memorial plaque there, because he just got it done right before he died.
Hey, buddy.
This is Beecher, and a lot of people want to touch wild animals, and so they figure, well, what if you breed wild animals to domestic cats? Could you have something that's very exotic looking and make a good pet? And what they get is a cat that looks like him, not terribly exotic looking, and they pee all over the house, and they want to eat raw meat, and they go after your German Shepherd, and in his case, he went after the girl's boyfriend and kept attacking him to the point where they finally had to get rid of him. So it's just, even when they're half Roaccutane they're not taking.
Well, I bet.
Is that his catnip that he's chewing on, that plant?
The cats will eat grass in order to bring up the bones and stuff that they can't digest, because they eat the bones and everything, the fur and all of that. Most of it they can pass, but sometimes there'll be remnants left in their stomach, so he'll eat that grass and then leave somebody a really great piece of vomit.
Well, maybe. It's Mother Nature's way,
yeah? Yeah, they know. There's a little circle out there in the plantation today.
What's he?
A black leopard. So oh, like black those leopards you just saw, but they come in black. Some people call them black panthers, but they're not really black panthers. I see you.
There he is.
You're so handsome.
Is this native to this area? Is that kind of panther that people talk about in the woods?
Where are they from, Carol?
Well, you're kind of right, because here in Florida, they're called Florida panthers.
Yeah.
And so all panthers are tan, because Florida panthers are cougars, so they're all brown or tan. Leopards, black leopards, actually come from Africa and from Asia, so they don't live here in the United States. But people tell me all the time that they saw a black panther in the woods, and usually what they have seen here in Florida, and usually what I think they've seen is probably a Florida panther or a bobcat at twilight, so they look dark, and they think they're black, but they're really not, they're brown.
Member of the church who lives in a rural area, and they have several relatives around, and they had a camera to kind of track deer, you know, and they had got a picture of a black cat, and they called it a panther, and that's in Kentucky.
Wow.
And
they escaped.
I didn't think that they would migrate that far into that climate, you know, and everything. But she said, well, there's this picture. And it's true. I mean, it was a big black cat.
Yeah.
And people had been saying, you know, they were sighting it. But that wasn't really the purpose of their film, but we showed up.
Wow. Yeah, like Mom said, a lot of people get these animals as pets, and so the leopards, not black leopards, but any of the leopards are the smartest of the cats. So if anybody's going to escape, it's going to be a leopard. And they're smart enough to survive once they get out there.
Yeah. Well, it looked healthy, you know. I mean, it wasn't skinny or anything like that.
Great numbers.
That place is vacant. Nobody there.
There's somebody in here. There she is down there.
Oh, she goes that far, huh?
Yeah, these cages are a lot bigger than you might think. They're all joined by tunnels and like habit rails.
man, this is something else.
These are servals, and they're kind of like cheetah. They can jump 12 feet straight up, so that's why all of their cages are
12 feet straight up?
Wow.
They could be basketball players, couldn't they? <Kentucky. laughs>
You think they might come recruit you?
They might.
Oh, look at that.
Well, if it was a bird.
Now, is this one fully grown? It's full grown? That's as large as it will be?
The what is?
Is this full grown?
Oh, yes. Yeah.
Okay. So they're a smaller cat.
Ooh, like that could be a house cat, doesn't it?
So there's no way to keep them in your backyard because they can jump any 6 foot fence.
Oh, yeah. That's true.
And she's one of the best hunters. You won't see squirrels inside the cages back here because this is all serval territory. Servals of all.
Have you ever seen her jump?
Oh, yeah. I've seen her go after squirrels at the top of the cage. Well, they'll get up at the trees above the cage.
You mean they actually jump?
Wow.
How tall is that fence?
I think it's 14.
Yeah, I'd say it did.
Wow.
Boy, that's amazing, isn't it? How the
Now, is she restless, or is that just their nature?
Well, they stay on the move, and so, you know, this is why Carol doesn't like to see them caged, is they like to be roaming miles and miles, so they have to do something.
Like
now the door stays open and she'll have the roam. She can go both.
We just put her in there while we're in there.
This
is the first time we've done who picks the team, but we do that kind of enrichment all the time where it's
not on yet.
Yeah, like if somebody's having a baby, they'll have a pink for girl or blue for boy. Babies. That's a new golf cart, Karen. That's nice.
Thank you. That was Howie getting upset with our other golf carts always being broken. And so he bought two of those really nice ones that are bigger because usually you get more than.
This is the way it fit my dog.
Oh, okay.
Oh, man, the golf schedule. Can two of them get along?
In their case, they were both really young when they came here, and one of them was living here and one was living down there, and they were calling to each other all the time, so we thought, you know, they might like each other. So what we did was we added on this piece of the cage, the old one, the brown one there was the one that was existing, and then there's a tunnel between the two cages, so we could shut a door and put a pine mesh over it so they can't get a paw through and get hurt, and once they got to where they were sleeping up there next to each other, then we felt like it was safe to open the door, and now they're chest buttons.
What is that? Well, that's good.
We did it on Valentine's Day, so every year on Valentine's Day we usually do some kind of
Halloween
thing. Since we don't let any of our keepers touch the cats, and all of our keepers love cats and want to touch cats, we do a foster program with the Humane Society in Tampa Bay. So they send us all their orphaned kittens, not all of them, but a lot of their orphaned kittens, and then the volunteers socialize them at night, and then, or the interns socialize them at night, and then during the day they come in here and they all play together and they do things with other cats, and all of our keepers play with them, so they get to be very socialized. I don't see any of them, usually those trees are full of kittens. We just had a bunch of them that got
adopted. Oh, cool.
This frame here, this is the size cage that Florida says you can keep one of those tigers in for their whole, two tigers actually, in for their entire life. And unfortunately, Florida's law is the most humane of all the other states. All the other states have smaller cages than that. So we think that's just...
You're talking about this or that?
Just that little frame of...
This is Florida's. This. But most states have the smaller here.
Right.
To the left.
All they have to be able to do is stand up.
Oh man, that'd be cool, wouldn't it? Excuse me. Thank you, old man. It says underneath it, there are ducks, no ducks on it.
These are a couple of my favorite tankers because they're the biggest and they actually go down into the lake. So this is Andy Tiger right here. And Seth Tiger has that one on the far side.
Good boy. Yeah.
Maybe she recognizes you.
They just like the golf carts because usually good things come on golf carts, treats and snacks.
Oh, I see. Are you allowed to feed them?
Not the public, but
yeah,
our
the
keepers
public.
Go out.
That's what.
Yeah.
And tell about the memorial wall. Isn't that where you put some of the cats?
Right. So you ask when the cats die, what do? We cremate them, and their remains go inside the wall.
Oh.
And then donors will sponsor the cat. So like every one of those plaques means somebody donated $500 to cover the cost of the necropsy and the cremation for that cat. And then they can put whatever text they want on there if it's in honor of a family member or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And it has a picture of the cat and the date of the cat's date of birth and date of death so that those cats are never forgotten. And on the back side of that wall, my dad created like little panels so that we can open it up and put the boxes of remains inside.
Mm-hmm.
That's very creative.
I mean, Carol has that ability and Jamie
so do
too.
You. So do you.
Yeah, but you and Jamie.
Mm-hmm.
This is our gift shop.
Oh, gift shop.
All of the cats are fed in little boxes like this that we call walkouts.
Hey, buddy. That water good, you're dropping some of it.
That water gets changed every single day.
Every single day.
And most of the cats have two or three water bowls because they drink a lot of water. We get them used to eating in that small space in case there is an emergency or if the vet needs to see them. So they get used to coming in there for stuff they like, food and treats.
Uh-huh.
And then if there were an emergency, we could call the cat in there and shut the door and tranquilize the cat.
I see. I guess you have to think ahead, don't you?
Yeah, because if, you know, some of these cages like that are so big, if we tranquilize a cat for a medical purpose and he goes out in the middle of the cage, we don't know if he's asleep or not when we go in there. We want to see he's asleep in a small spot.
Yeah.
Hey.
I'll go get another round.
What are you doing, Seth? Hey, Candy.
The other day, you're probably ready to give this to her.
I know. You think I'd stay away.
Seth has
he's
about 2 acres
the guy,
out there.
Isn't he?
And the only reason that we feel like it's safer for him to be in that kind of a cage that doesn't have the angle at the top is because both of those boys were used as cub petting props when they were little.
Uh-huh.
And the only way that they can use them is if they're small enough that they can't take off a finger or hurt somebody. So the people that do that starve them and don't give them the proper calcium, so they end up with really bad teeth and bones.
Uh-huh.
And both of these cats, when they were cubs, apparently had broken a back leg. And it didn't feel right, so they're not good climbers, so that's why they're safe.
I see.
People always ask, what do you do in a hurricane? And so,
yeah,
you know,
what
a tree
do you
would just go right over and be a ramp out if it were a cat were in there. So all of the cages that are open have a roof section, like this piece up front. And if the winds get up over 20 miles an hour, our protocol is to haul them into those roof sections until the winds come.
Well, you had to think of everything, don't you?
Just about everything we do, there was some incident that spawned it.
Yeah. You know, thank you.
Learned the hard way. This opening you see up here is the Keeper Cafe, so our volunteers have a place where they can go and have lunch, and we provide them with snacks and drinks. And this big freezer can store 17,000 pounds of raw meat. We feed 500 pounds of raw meat every single day to all of these cats. And then the little freezer, we have whole racks of whole rabbits in it because they need that whole body for the nutrition.
Uh-huh.
And then this building is, most of it, half of it is a huge walk-in cooler. And then the rest of it is like sinks and stuff where they can prepare the food. Do you think they want to go in the hospital or in the food prep?
Well,
that'd be of interest.
Just
in the hospital.
I think so. If nobody's in there.
Well, there is somebody in this hospital, so we can't go in there. But we can go in our big one. The little one is our recovery hospital, so it has two rooms for cats who are recovering. And we do bobcat rehab and release. So if bobcats get hit by cars, then we can fix them up and send them back to the wild, where if they get orphaned.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a cat in there right now who broken 3 bones. He still managed to survive it and tangle with a car. So she's got to be kept inside in a small space for a while.
Quite interesting.
I'm sure they've got brochures or something. She was talking about the watching it on and everything. I think that's something that my granddaughters would like to look at.
Absolutely.
Oh, wait a minute.
Sorry.
I'm too slow.
We're going to leave you behind.
Yeah. Leading with my bum knee, maybe I should have led with the other one.
Yeah, my left knee's bad too. Tom, we have only one biblical cat name. You want to tell him about that cat name?
Joseph?
Yeah, Moses.
Oh, well, Joseph was in the
Bible. Well, that's you're right, but that doesn't.
Yeah, Joseph too.
And we had a Malachi. Moses, I understand now, I'm thinking about it, why you would say it was a biblical name, because that was actually why he got his name. I went out, dealing with volunteers or even staff. People are just messy and they don't always do what they're supposed to. And I went out to the front gate one day and somebody had left a pet carrier out there. And I was like, man, you're just not putting stuff away. I was so mad and I picked that thing up. And when I did, I hear this kazoom inside. And I turned it around and there's a baby bobcat in there. Oh. Somebody had left it at our front gate. So since he was kind of left in a box, like a baby in the bushes,
how do you do? How do you give a big class from school to this kind of school?
They break them up into groups of 25, and so each group of 25 will have a person leading the tour and one person following the tour to keep all the kids together. Uh-huh. And we do about 100 of those classes a year. There's a bobcat up in the bridge.
Hey, buddy.
That might be Moses. Are you Moses? I can't tell. Moses and Bailey live in there together, but they look the same from this side.
Do they ever get territorial about where they want to sleep or anything? Do they? Of course, most of them are in the cage by themselves anyway, aren't they?
Yeah, there's the other one up on top of the platform there.
Okay, yeah.
The only thing they usually fight over is food. They don't fight over napping spots because there's just plenty of napping spots.
Don't shoot.
During Hurricane Irma, this tree fell over and took out part of one of our cages and took out part of the tour waiting area.
Well, I guess you're kind of getting anxious about along that time, don't you?
Yeah, because we were inside the building when it went.
Oh.
And so we had to get up and come fix all of that in the middle of Hurricane Irma, which was really scary.
People work for you, say?
They do. Mm-hmm. Those are volunteers that live there, and the gift shop manager lives there. That cage back there is empty right now because the resident who lives in there, he's the only animal here who's not a cat. He's an African genet. We call him the leopard weasel. He looks like a weasel with leopard spots. And he's over 20 years old. We found him 20 years ago wandering around the neighborhood, and they're from Africa, so he wasn't native. And they usually only live to be about 9. 9 is like the max you ever see them live online, and so now he can't regulate his body temperature anymore, so we just moved him into one of our offices, so he has his own office here now. This little house was a house that I bought when I bought a chicken farm. It was the sales office for the front of the chicken farm, so we put it up on a flatbed roll and took it out here, and when we tried to take it off the flatbed, it rolled off the flatbed. And so we pushed it upright, but we had no equipment to pick it back up on this end, so it stayed right here. So we call it the turnover house.
Oh, I see. It's got a good name. Got a good name out of the deal, didn't it?
And every Friday and Saturday we have keeper tours. So when people come for a keeper tour, they actually make all of those kinds of enrichment things that you saw us handing out.
Uh-huh.
They make the treats and then they go with the keeper to watch them being handed out.
Well.
This cat right here is Siberian lynx, which would obviously be native to Siberia.
Hey, buddy. Rough life, isn't it?